Welcome back, everyone. I'd like to apologize for yesterday's video. My playing was sloppy and unfocused. My commentary was rushed and kind of all over the place. And the music was choppy and not up to my usual standards of quality. So if you made it through the whole thing, thank you. I'm going to try to make future videos better. I think I'm going to have to accept that for games like this, I'm just going to have to stop focusing so much on always having something to say and just focus on playing the game and just let the commentary come naturally. That's something that I'm historically not the best at, which is why I typically play games like Mario that don't require a whole lot of focus and concentration, so I can kind of yammer on without worrying about it, and that's something I'm going to have to work on. So. I'm not going to skip anything. I'm just going to start that level, start level 12 at the beginning once more. I was going to play through it and just start the video in the middle of the level, but one death isn't really enough to resort to those kind of tactics yet. So I will start with level 12 at the beginning. And before we start, I just wanted to show you guys the fear. This is straight from the Dungeon Hack Manual, and I guess I just forgot about it because it is listed among the other manuals. It's listed as a fear, not a greater fear, but I'm pretty sure they're exactly the same thing. Or the game doesn't make a distinction between fear and greater fear. It doesn't really give any helpful information, just kind of a physical description and some lore information. Nothing about what their weaknesses are or what their attacks are, so you know how to deal with them. But I looked it up in the FAQ on Game Facts, and it turns out that these fear's attacks ignore your armor class, which is why I was kind of getting so thoroughly trashed. So just thought that might be interesting for some of you. Let's see if we can do a little better this time. And I have not skipped anything. We are starting exactly where we started at the beginning of the last video, and I'm going to try to stay more focused, try to concentrate on playing the game as well as possible, and not so much always having things to say. So the first thing I have to do is redo all my spells. And since none of the enemies on this level have any special attacks or anything that I need to protect myself against, I want to focus entirely on healing and damage dealing. The fear is an evil creature, but I don't think protection from evil works. According to the fact, the only buff that protects you against the fear is improved, I think it's improved invisibility. That gives you an armor class bonus that actually works against the fear. I don't think protection from evil will do anything. So just go straight Cure Light Wounds for level 1. I want to stick with the Spiritual Hammer because I don't know what else to go with. I'm pretty sure Flame Blade, I mean, I tried that a few levels down and it didn't really seem to help me that much. No poison on this level, so I can just forget about those. Whole Person, I think I tried it in the last video, that didn't work either. I guess it's worth another shot. Magical Vestment doesn't really do me that much good. I mean, a higher armor class helps against the trolls, but the trolls aren't really that much of a threat on this level. Prayer, I'm pretty sure that doesn't do me any good either. I'm pretty sure none of this stuff actually helps me. Yeah, I mean, I really don't know what to take. Don't need free action on this level. Let's get a couple cause serious wounds. I don't know. It's worth a shot, I guess. Keep one true seeing and take two cure critical and two cause critical. And I'll take Soul Searing Orb. I think I'm done with that spell for good. But I haven't really tried harm yet, so I guess there's no harm in trying it. LOL. I do want to keep two heals, though. The musical selection is Kingsfield 4, which was suggested by Demi Sneed. So thank you for the suggestion. Actually, I don't know anything about this game. I kind of looked up a playlist on YouTube, and I'm just going with that. Hopefully this video isn't more than an hour, because I'll have to go ahead and restart the playlist, since I don't have a way to do that automatically. Poor Turn Undead. Such a neglected spell. I mean, I'll use prayer, but I'm not going to be too concerned about keeping it equipped on me at all times. Okay, I think I'm finally ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and save it here, just so if I do have to start this video over again, I won't have to go through all that garbage. Oops. I didn't mean to rest again. We are off to a great start, guys. Great, great start. I meant to break camp, not rest. I'm not going to restart this video, though, because I'm trying... Just trying not to worry so much. I'll be honest, I felt a little stressed out at the end of that last video. And I'm trying to stay calmer this time. Whether it'll work remains to be seen. Okay. I guess I could have just loaded my game instead of going through all that again. Oh man. Okay. So yeah, there's no spells that work better against the fears. Nothing. I mean, there's really no strategy to use against them. Just pray to God they don't gang up on you. Because really, I could handle one at a time. It was when I had to fight two or more at the same time. I don't even know how it hit me. It was turned away from me when I started running away. Oh, great. Speaking of getting ganged up on, I actually didn't want to go through this teleporter yet. Alright, I know it's tedious to watch me do this, but this is the best thing I have going for me, trying to deal with these fears. Let's try Firestorm. Don't know if that did any good. Let's try Cause Critical. The spell dissipates harmlessly into the ether, because I forgot I wasn't facing the teleporter. Duke of the Bone misses the monster. Well, at least it gave me an indication. That was a weird way of saying that. An indication of whether the spell actually hit. Oh, that was Cure Serious, not Cause Serious. Duke of the Bone misses the monster. See, I wish it gave me that more often. Okay, well, that seems to be kind of a bust. What else do I have here? Harm? Let's try it. Duke of the Bone misses the monster. Oh, that seems to be a recurring theme. Guys, this is going to be a long, tedious video. And if you want to skip this one, I'm not going to blame you. Hopefully the next level will have some monsters I can dispatch a little more easily than these. According to Kostya, this is one of the most, if not the most difficult enemy in this game. So hopefully, once this level's done with, I won't run into these things again. Of course, who knows? The game might decide it wants to throw these at me for the next 6 levels. In which case, I'll make it through it. I might cry, but I'll get through it eventually. I really don't know how this game works at the higher levels. So the fears could be... I mean, they could make a return. It's a little surprising that I didn't even run to one as a boss or anything before the game started throwing them at me. Okay, that's the chainmail that's not better than what I have. Alright, before I go into this teleporter, I want to explore as much of the map as I can without teleporting around. Because I feel like when I started teleporting around, I started aggroing monsters in other areas that I wouldn't have aggroed otherwise if I had just left the teleporters alone until I was ready for them. Now, they don't always follow you through the teleporter, but I felt like some of them did follow me, and now these trolls are... Maybe I should probably keep my shield equipped as much as possible. I thought the trolls wouldn't be that much of a threat, but they're doing some serious damage. But yeah, I think going through the teleporters before I had the rest of the map cleared out, it confused me, and it made me more nervous about where I was and what I was facing. Like, I would run away, and I would try to go through the teleporter, and there were more monsters there, and I would freak out, and it ended badly for me. You know, maybe I should cast 2 spiritual hammers and keep, or hell, I could cast 3 or 4 of them and keep the extras here in my hotbar. So when my hammers take a while to return, when they take longer to return than it takes for my hand to refresh, I'll have another spiritual hammer at the ready to cast. What is... Okay. What's this? Amulet of Magic Missiles. That's the amulet that I don't know what it does, but I better keep wearing it just in case it's saving my life. And I don't know about it. I mean, I guess I have 4 of them, and I'm typically only using 1 of them per rest period. So, I mean, I might as well. Of course, that'll mean a lot more fumbling around in my inventory. But I might be able to make it work for me. Of course, in small hallways like this, it doesn't matter because the hammer always returns to me before my hand cools down, so to speak. Dang it. Oh my god, that thing just did 32 points of damage to me. That's insane. I only have like 60 something hit points. How many hit points do I have? Oh, 79. Still. That's still almost half my health in one hit. I'd just like to point out that I looked these things up in the wiki equivalent of the monster manual, and under rarity it said very rare for both the fear and the greater fear. This music kind of sounds like the intro to Paranoid Android by Radiohead. That's weird. I mean, it's different enough that, you know, it's clearly different, but... Okay, there's that wand that I found, and the scroll telling me to worry about wands of haste monster, but this was a wand of fireballs, not haste monster. But yeah, like I was saying, they are listed in the monster manual as very rare, so I'd like to know how there are 50 of them down here in this dungeon. Maybe that's why they're rare, because 99% of them are concentrated in this one location. This is like the spawning point for all fears. The sum of all fears, if you will. Wow, this really sounds like a weird instrumental version of Paranoid Android. Like, it has the same kind of minor key. A very similar progression. I wonder if I can use Dispel Magic on those traps. I don't know if they're magical in nature or not. I don't think I've ever used Dispel Magic in this playthrough. Alright, I should probably start thinking about resting, since all of my good healing is done for. It's donezo. I'll go a little while longer. Alright, once I get knocked down a little bit more, I'll rest again. Well, something just opened this door. And that something is a troll. I do think these are tougher than the trolls I fought a few levels down. Either they're tougher or I just haven't improved at all. Because they're similar in toughness and strength to the trolls I fought, you know, when I was 5 levels lower than I am now. The thing about gaining levels in this game, though, or at least in Dungeon Hack, I don't know about in 2nd edition D&D in general, but eventually you just reach a point of diminishing returns, because I have every level of spell I'm going to get, and going up levels doesn't increase your stats or anything. The only thing it increases, other than the spells you have access to and your hit points, well, that's it, the spells you have access to and your hit points. Oh no. Okay, it is now resting time. Anything I'm going to do differently? I don't think so. Yeah, I like this multiple spiritual hammer strategy, though. If I get in another situation where I'm just standing here waiting for my hammer to come back, it'll be good to have a backup. Oh, you know what? Oops. I clicked no because I thought that would cancel me out of the resting, but all that did was make it so I didn't use healing spells. I was going to cast Crave Food and Water before I rested, but I can just go ahead and cast that now. Of course, that just increases the amount of time I have to spend on spell preparation, but it's okay. I'm done worrying about how long these videos take. They take as long as they take. That's how it's going to be from now on. I probably should have switched out Cause Critical and Cause Serious Wounds. It didn't seem to do that much. I mean, I missed with all of them, and I missed with Harm. So, yeah, damage dealing spells, not the cleric's forte. Okay, there's like three of them down there, but I should have enough room to maneuver around and deal with them, hopefully. Actually, let me check my map just to make sure. Okay. Yeah, I should be fine. I managed to miss those spikes. Oh, good. Uh-oh. One snuck up behind me. That's kind of a jerk move. Realize what these things remind me of. They remind me of Krang from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. The living brain part, not the body that the living brain was embedded in. Brains are just the grossest things. I don't like them. I saw a video of a biologist or a doctor or a veterinarian or something demonstrating a cow's brain. And usually when you see a cow's brain or an animal's brain, it's given some sort of fixing agent, I guess you would call it, to make it firm. And the video demonstrated that when you have a brain that doesn't have any of that, the brain is like really amorphous and kind of gooey. It was really disgusting. I don't know why I'm talking about it. Yeah, not a fan of brains. I really hope these things can't spawn faster than I can kill them. Oh, I click cause critical instead of cure critical. It's another downside to having the cause wound spells in your arsenal. Higher potential for misclicks. Let's see, Brasky. Okay, so is that all I can explore before I go into a teleporter? It looks like it. Unless there's a hidden door or something that I didn't find. But I have true seeing on, so I probably would have found one if one was there. Oh, that's just the journal page. Possible I found one of those Wands of Haste Foe and didn't realize it. I'm not sure if they self-identify or not. Yeah, really disappointed that True Seeing isn't as useful as I thought it was going to be. I guess there's just nothing you can do about those Dark Zones. I mean, it'd be kind of nice if there was like a torch or a lamp or something that you could use, even if it had a limited number of uses or it was on a time limit or something. Just something to help you deal with those dark areas. I guess I haven't really found a dark area where I wasn't able to find my way. Like that door is not locked or there's no button that I have to blindly click for or anything like that. That would be a real drag. Of course, it is a little annoying to have to lure these enemies out every time, but I guess it could be worse. I'm a gigantic brain. Oh, did I kill it? Where did it go? I guess I got it. Don't see how that happened. Great. Please just be a troll. Trolls are so much easier to deal with. I guess I could try flinging hammers just like this. I don't know if that's as effective as using the one in my hand or not. Doesn't look like it. They don't seem to hit when I do it like that. I know in my last dungeon hack playthrough, I was going with like a hammer in each hand, and I was throwing multiple hammers that way. But that seems like a little more than I want to have to manage in this playthrough. Come on. I know you can smell me. Wow, that thing's being a jerk. Ooh, wow. that's a dangerous room. Maybe I should just ignore this room. You know what? I think I'm going to do that. There can't be anything in there that's worth dealing with that many fears in a dark area. Oh, I was going to use cause critical wounds on that troll, but I got him. Maybe I should just forget about trying to explore the entire level. What I should be doing is I should just be looking for the exit, trying to get to the exit as fast as possible. Of course, the problem with that is you can't just run by all these monsters, because if I do that, I'm going to get in a situation where I'm stuck and just get clobbered. Get surrounded by enemies and like this. Kinda like that. Good job, Duke. Good going. Okay, where's my wand of teleportation? Here it is. That wand of teleportation to save my ass. Come on. So yeah, no more superfluous rooms, at least on level 12. Level 13 might have monsters that it's easier for me to deal with, and if that's the case, I'll be more about the exploration. Okay, these are just trolls, so I'm a little safer here than I thought I was. Still don't want to get surrounded, though. I don't want my wand of distance to run out of charges at an inopportune time. Oh, great. That fear is out of its cell. Alright. How many heals do I have? Okay, I still have two of them. Good. I wonder how many fears there are in that room I passed by. Oh, okay. I thought there were like three of them in here. Maybe they teleported somewhere else. I still haven't determined if that phasing thing actually lets them teleport or not. I don't think it does. I think it's just a weird way to represent an enemy's attack. Alright. And like I figured, there wasn't anything worth going into that room for. Slow and steady, Duke. Not only does it win the race, it also keeps you alive. Thank you. Aw, it makes my life so much easier when you just come through the teleporter. Don't you want to make my life easy? Okay, these things are definitely 33 points of damage. I was going to say they're definitely teleporting around, but I don't know how sure I am about that. I don't know. It really looked like one of them just kind of jumped from one square to another. I could try harm. God, as soon as I step through this teleporter, I'm just going to get assaulted by three of them. Maybe I should try this other teleporter. See, there's three of them in this room. I could try running past them, see where that leads, but that would probably not be wise. Alright, let's try that other teleporter. See if it leads somewhere a little less unbearable. Where was it? Okay, it's down there. Oh, wait. That's the other one. Okay, never mind. Yeah, I'm probably going to have to restart this YouTube playlist, but it's okay. Taking a few seconds to do that won't be that big of a deal. Usually I'm playing music in my media player of choice, FUBAR 2000, and I just have it on repeat, so once it's over, I can just continue and not have to worry about it. Oh, great. Exactly what I wanted to see as soon as I stepped through that teleporter. Okay, you know what would be really nice is if I just found the stairs, just kind of stumbled across them. See, normally that would be bad because, well, it wouldn't be bad, but it wouldn't be that useful because I want to explore the whole level. But in this level, I'm not really that worried about it. Or, you know, a pit leading down to the next level, that would also be, that would be fine. I'd be A-okay with that. I mean, I have a ring of feather falling. See, I didn't kill that thing. It must have teleported away, which is why it seems like there are so many of those things. Or one of the reasons. How many of those have I killed? Oops. Oh yeah. See, I've only killed 16 of them. Seems like way more than that. Some of those quote-unquote deaths were just teleporting away. I'm pretty sure these things, I mean, nothing I read indicated that they have that ability, but that really looks like what's going on here. Okay, that was a death. You can tell it's a legitimate death because of the way it flashes white like that. I love how this thing's attack animation, it's just kind of thrusting his face into you. Okay, I was getting ready to use another hammer, because this is quite a long hallway. But I'm almost at the end of it, so shouldn't need to do that here. I guess I shouldn't have been so glib about these trolls. They're still a threat. whether because they're a more powerful version of the trolls or because my character just isn't that much better than he was the first time he fought the trolls. It's hard to say. But yeah, trolls are no joke. Wow, this thing is just completely disregarding. Oh, he was. He had his back turned to me, and I just repeatedly missed him with my hammer. He didn't even notice I was trying to kill him. That's an insult. Cleric level 18. Oh yeah, that's right. I was 17 when I started the last video. Or I guess I was. I actually don't remember hitting level 17. That thing almost killed me in one hit. Alright, it's resting time. I have more spells now, yay. Doesn't matter. Yeah, cause serious and cause critical don't really seem worth it. Neither did slay living when I tried it last time. Okay, I'll try slay living again instead of cause critical and see if that does anything for me. I'll take another cure critical. Let's get another heal actually. There was that one time when I rested and I didn't have all my spells afterwards. Maybe I just ended the resting prematurely or something. I'm not sure. One thing's for sure, I'm really glad I don't have to worry about food. Can you imagine me playing through this level, having to worry about starving to death the whole time? I mean, I'm still finding food, but it's few and far between. I'll hold on to those rations just in case, and just cast Great Food and Water. Alright, Fear. I'm ready to face my fears. I have to say, this track that's playing right now on the soundtrack, not great. It's a little... I don't know, simplistic, I guess. Which way was I going again? Oh yeah. Man. Imagine doing this without a map too. That's basically what Eye of the Beholder would be. Huh. Well, I've exhausted all of my other options. I have to go back into this room with the three fears. That's going to be a lot of fun. Alright, so I need to go up and around. And there are three more enemies that respawn in here. Great. Yeah, don't need to deal with that one though. My dexterity must be better than I thought. I'm handling those spike traps pretty well. Actually, I don't know if that would be a dexterity thing or some kind of saving throw. I don't think there was a saving throw versus trap, but I might be mistaken. Alright, this music is better. I've enjoyed all of it so far except for that one track. The weird kind of improvisational sounding sinister jazz track thing. Alright, so I need to go down to this one and that'll take me in here. Okay. Man, I wish there was some kind of like AoE attack I could use that would just incinerate all three of those fears. But I don't have anything like that. I could try Slay Living. See, the problem is I don't know if I'll be facing an enemy when I go in, and if I spend too much time trying to orient myself, I might get surrounded. So it's a little risky. And exactly what I said would happen happened. Okay. Well, where's my wand of distance? Here we go. Alright, so I teleported that one from here to up here, which isn't the best teleport that could have happened, but at least I'm able to get out now. Did I kill one of them, or did it teleport away? I can't tell. Well, I slayed it, I guess. I don't know, it didn't do the white flash that usually means death. So I can't be 100% sure. Maybe that weird phasing animation it does just conflicts with the death animation or something. Maybe the game gets confused when it tries to do both of those animations at once. So maybe some of the times when it does the phasing animation and it disappears, that means I'm actually killing it. And the game just, harm. Uh-oh. Okay, so I need to... What do I need to do here? I need to drink a potion of invisibility. Well, no. Actually, yeah, that might actually work. Alright. Well, this has been Let's Play Dungeon Hack. I'm not ready to give up yet. But maybe you are. If you are, I don't blame you. But tomorrow we'll get right back on that horse. See you then.